Welcome back to Politics Now.
Nevada Congresswoman Susie Lee represents the most evenly split district in the entire state of Nevada. She sat down to talk with us about gun control bills, her thoughts on impeachment, and that upcoming 2020 race. Take a look. Let's just start with the 800-pound issue right off the bat. Do you think we ought to ban semi-automatic military-style assault weapons that have been used in many of these mass shootings in the past few weeks?
Absolutely. I mean, that, first of all, you know, this is an issue that hits very close to home to anyone in our community having suffered through October 1. And, you know, what was interesting, I was with a couple colleagues a couple weeks ago, one from Colorado, one from Florida, one from South Carolina. All of us have had horrific mass shootings in our community, and it wasn't, we weren't there for that reason. And so it's just going to show that this this is a national crisis.
Legally speaking, do you think a bill would survive scrutiny in the Supreme Court as it's presently constituted?
You know what? We're never going to know until we try. And I think that the American public is demanding some sort of action on gun safety. And we've already done it in the House. We passed the background checks, universal background checks bill, which is sitting on Mitch McConnell's desk right now.
Even if we did this solemn inquiry, as you're talking about, and looked into this, passed what you thought were solid articles of impeachment, the chances are that the Senate would not convict, and so it would just be an exercise. Would that help or hurt President Trump, you think?
You know what? I think that for me as a member of Congress, I need to really focus on upholding the Constitution of the United States and doing my due diligence and making my decision. And, you know, I don't think it should come down to political, does it help or does it hurt? Mm-hmm. It's bottom line is, has he violated the Constitution? Has he obstructed justice? And make the decision based on that. I mean, you know, what really concerns me is the obstruction that is rampant throughout this administration. You know, I'm on the Veterans Affairs Committee. I'm the chairwoman of the Electronic Health Record Modernization Subcommittee. I mean, even getting information out of Veterans Affairs, you think would be something that's relatively bipartisan. We're trying to do right by veterans. Even that type of information, sometimes it's hard to get.
Are you nervous at all about this election, or how do you feel it's more than a year out? How do you feel at this point?
Yeah, I mean, you know, listen, elections are elections, right? And so certainly you have to be, it's in the back of my mind. But again, I'm here to serve people of Nevada's 3rd District. And I can't tell you what an honor it is to be in Washington representing Southern Nevada. And so when I make a vote, when I wake up in the morning and just, you know, when I'm out in the community, that's really what I'm focusing on is how does it impact, does it move our country forward? How does it impact the constituents of the 3rd Congressional District? Clearly, morally, can I agree with that?
Well, we also talked with Congresswoman Lee about health care, budget deficits, and her valiant efforts to stop the scourge of robocalls that just keep coming. You can watch her answers to those questions on our website. That's 8newsnow.com. Well, CNN holds a town hall exclusively devoted to climate change.
We got to start choosing science over fantasy here.
It lasted 7 hours, but don't worry, we'll give you the most memorable moments from that event that's coming up next. And Commissioner Tick Seggerbloom is already endorsing his candidate for president in 2020. Who is he supporting? We'll tell you next.